Conspiracy theorist MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell was jettisoned from Twitter Sunday just hours after trying to slip back on and circumvent a permanent ban for constantly lying. Hello everybody, I'm back on Twitter. My only account is at Mike Lindell. Please already unfollow to spread the word, Lindell wrote in a tweet, Business Insider reported. He also posted a video urging people, please share with everybody you know, let everybody you know, so we can get the word out at Twitter in case they do take it down. Thanks a lot for helping out. Lindell was permanently banned from the social media platform last year for using it to disseminate conspiracy theories and lies about the presidential election. Several Twitter users flagged the new profile as violating the company's ban evasion policy, which prohibits attempts to circumvent being shut out, including through the creation of new accounts. The account was shut down after Lindell's attempt to circumvent his ban. Lindell told the Daily Beast that his ejection from Twitter again was a shame. He added in a stunning non sequitur, "We need to melt down the voting machines and turn them into prison bars." Lindell likely thought he would be welcomed back on Twitter now that Tesla CEO and multi-billionaire Elon Musk is buying the company for $44 billion. Musk has been touting an anything-goes policy for Twitter. In what appeared to be another strategy to get his spot back on Twitter, Lindell was asking at the political rally in Nebraska Sunday if anyone knew Musk so he could talk to him about voting machines. Longtime Trump confidant and self-described political dirty trickster Roger Stone also tried to get back on Twitter last week, but his account, too, was quickly taken down, also for violating Twitter's ban evasion policy. He was kicked off Twitter in 2017 after viciously attacking CNN journalists for reporting on Kremlin interference in the 2016 presidential campaign. Stone was sentenced in early 2020 to 40 months in prison for multiple felonies, including witness tampering, lying to Congress and obstructing the House investigation into possible collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia in the 2016 race. He was pardoned by Trump.